we are definitely at an inflection point. We're at a point right now where an original series and it does well, you can make $1 million, or you can make more than $1 million, and you can build up an audience of millions and millions of people. So I don't think the industry is becoming more structured per se in terms of how content needs to be presented, or that there are more restrictions on our world. I just think it's evolving and that there's real money there.
So is it reality shows? I'm a journalist, and I worry about news and how to present news. Is Blip a place for news that can live, and what would be your advice be for it to find an audience there?
Yeah, I mean, absolutely. We've just divided our destination site, our new destination site at blip.tv that we launched on May 17th, into 16 different categories, and news is one of them. So absolutely. And you should know that the founders, including myself, come from the news world and are really passionate about it. I was a news reporter before we started the company. So absolutely. The key, and this is true with all categories, is that you have to be consistent, and you have to know the audience that you're going after and super serve that audience. You can't just produce the content. You should respond to comments. You should Facebook, promote your content on Facebook.
You're talking about being social.
Yeah, be social. But I mean, basically, market the heck out of this stuff. It's what I was saying on stage a bit. You can't just create your content and expect a check. It doesn't work that way. You need to think about yourself as an entrepreneur. As an entrepreneur, you can't just have a product. You also have to market that product and have PR, and you have to work it and earn your audience to grow your audience.
Well, let me ask you specifically about Blip. Are there ways to have success on Blip that might be a different than another platform, say YouTube or Ustream?
No, I mean, I think it's all pretty similar. Look, we syndicate our content to YouTube. The key is consistency. Produce content that is of a somewhat similar length on an as regular basis as possible. Most of the top shows on Blip are producing every day or every other day or at least twice a week. And their audience looks forward to that new content just as you would look forward to a new episode of your favorite TV show.
When you're saying produced, is this like a production, or can I do 15 minutes live? And what's the best time to do it, 15, 30, 45 an hour?
Yeah. Our average episode length of a top show on Blip is 17 minutes now, but you shouldn't feel constricted. Part of the beauty of the web is that the content should be as long as you think it should be. No, oh, absolutely. I mean, we have shows that are 44 minutes long that keep their viewers 100% of the way through and do very, very well. So just the key is to be consistent about it and keep producing content. And that word produce, I say with a small p. No, if you're doing just talking about something that you're passionate about, that's great. In fact, the content that is not scripted for whatever reason tends to be more popular right now at this moment, summer 2011, than the scripted content.
Very good. So this is Mo Krokmal from Internet Week, and we've been talking to Dina of blip.tv, and we'll have more on social media news ny.com. Thanks.